I just got a call from Grandma Caprio, who said you need to talk to me about something. What is it?
That's all I need. You two yentas on the phone.
What are you telling her? I'm on the other line of coaching
and
you.
And here come friends the car.
Tell her you're not on the heroin no more, huh?
You're a good boy.
Hey, I'm not on heroin anymore. Oh, Artie, I'm so happy. Tell her you love her dog. Oh, come on, Grandma Caprio.
Tell her no.
Did she? She also, she did comment on the dice thing once. She said, did that guy pay you? And I said, yeah, I said, yeah.
Never mind, shut up, you cousine.
Cousine.
Tell her you're no more on the China White. No more China White for my Artie. Tell her, Artie. Hey, I'm not on the China White no more. Oh, Artie, that's so wonderful. Tell her you love her dog.
I think you invented the dueling Arties. I hear forever.
Hey, I love your dog. Oh, Artie, I'm more in love than ever. You're doing good. Artie, you're selling a Mercedes and buying an IROC. Hey, I'm buying an IROC. Oh, Artie, you're the perfect Italian orphan.
My last car almost was a Monte SS.
Artie, I love you. Thank you, Day. And thank you, Grandma Caprio. Artie, I'm here knitting you a beautiful wedding goomboline. A wedding goomboline? I ain't wearing no goomboline to my wedding. Shut up with the Jews who wear a yarmulke. You wear a goomboline, man.
No more of that.
You know what a goopaline is? I'll tell you exactly what it is.
A goopaline.
In Godfather 2, when Frankie Pantangeli's brother comes from Italy to sit in court,
he's wearing the goopaline.
He's got a goopaline.
For God's sake, so when you go out there with a Dane, get the shit stains out of your underwear. You're bringing your underpants over to a Grandma Caprio's house.
Grandma Caprio better give Dana her meatball recipe if she wants Dana to keep her.
Fuck her! I don't give anybody my meatball recipe. That's just for me and my auntie.
You had such a hard life to end like this with you making fun.
Poor Grandma Caprio.
But the fans did love that. They all had their own camera.
Ralph, you're on the air.
A goopaline.
Hey, it's an actual word, Ralph. What do you want me to tell you?
Artie, I got some gabagool for you.
You heard that, Sorella. You heard it before.
I never heard a goopaline. What the fuck is that?
All right, whatever.
Hey, so, Howard, did you play the part of where Dice, had a meltdown on that guy who was heckling?
Yeah, I'm getting there now.
This part's so good.
All right, thanks.
And then play the part where, 5 minutes later, the guy gets back in.
All right, I'll get
now,
to it.
Now, Rob, would you replay it? You enjoyed listening.
I did, because it was like a bit of a train wreck. Like, you couldn't hear Artie. The crowd was mic'd great.
Yeah.
Good job on mic'ing the crowd. But,
they forgot the performers.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, thank you.
Later.
All right, let's see.
Yeah, what happened was Jim McClure was off to the side of the stage. He was supposed to tell me exactly when we were going on.
Uh-huh.
So I looked at him like a half an hour into my set, and he goes, 2 minutes. So I do another bit. I'm trying to time out what the fuck is 2 minutes. And I figure, okay, it's 2 minutes. I look over at Jim, and he goes, 2 minutes.
Great. All right, Dice Clay gets heckled, and he gets the heckler tossed out.
Wow. You're choking the phone a little. Don't you think she calls you right back? Don't you think that the phone ring ring? Hello? Did you just hang up on me? Did you just say you're all fucking ignoramus? But this is you today. People today, you'd rather use your phone than bang a chick with a nice fat ass like this. I would never even go with a chick this good looking. You understand? You don't go with a chick this good looking, because when you come down the block, you know how people look at you. You know, wait, there's one fucking guy just begging for attention before I continue.
Boy, this is a tough crowd.
I gotta say, and there were guys backstage who owned the place, and I've worked for these guys before. The guy who owns the place is the nicest guy, and he was telling me to go back up there, and I said, dude,
come back up.
What? I said, dude, you have no idea, the comedy gods, you just do not do that. God. I said, that guy's a legend.
What do you mean, you mean just walk
look
up in the middle of the
set?
The guy was like, hey, you should, you know, they're yelling for you, just to calm him down. He goes, you want to go, well, calm down and listen to Dice. I said, dude, you have no idea. First of all, if there was a comedy mafia, they'd have a hit on me for doing that. That's just disrespectful.
Although, if somebody paid to see Dice, why are they talking through the whole thing?
That's the thing. Like, I explained to him, I said, look, guys, you knew that I was opening. You knew I was set on the air. Clearly, I'm doing 20 minutes to a half an hour, which I ended up doing longer because McClure kept it to 2 minutes.
What was Dice like when he came off stage, or were you gone already?
No. Well, what happened was, how he ended it was, and again, I think this is all funny, part of the persona. He has his 16-year-old son, Max, bring up another leather jacket. He has a leather jacket, and he goes, Max! And his kid brings up a studded leather jacket with all diamonds, and the sleeves are cut off, and then he goes into the nursery rhymes. So he does four of the nursery rhymes in a row. That's how he ends, and people seem to like that, but still the crowd was just a hostile mess in the middle, and he was fine. You know, again, the VH1 cameras were on, so he came over to me, he said, good job, I think that was great, it was...
Let's go play Giant Stadium.
I mean, God bless the guy, he thinks we're playing Giant Stadium, and I would love to, it would be great.
So here the heckler gets tossed out, we're still working toward that, right. Okay.
This fucking guy. You fucking drunken asshole, you dumb fuck. Yeah, you cocksucker face. How about I come down there and knock the fucking shit out of you? How would you like that?
There you
fine little beast motherfucker. I'll bend you over. I'll paint kids on your back, you fat fuck. You'll be my bitch, asshole face. Yeah, cocksucker face, I'm talking to you. You dumb fuck. Bend over, hey. Hey, bend over. Yeah, you're the part of the cum that dripped down your mother's leg. How's this sound? I fucked your mother in the ass, and she had you. That's all. That's what I think of you. You oversized fucking cow. You slob. You fucking prick. Get the fuck out of here. Get him the fuck out of here. Go ahead, fatso. Go ahead. You fucking zero of a human being. Get him the fuck out of here now.
You know, it would have been a cool show if you just threw out the whole audience.
The guy's going a zero. It was depressing because the guy looked exactly like me. But the other thing was one guy got so close to the stage... There was almost a physical altercation. And,
that would have been good.
And what happened was, when Dice got backstage, I said, Dice, if that guy hit you, will you? He goes, yeah, I would have hit him. But he had to wait for the guy to hit him.
That'd be a good show, be like, you know, this is what you hear.
Yeah, right. At one point, Dice even said, he goes, I don't know what the fuck this sounds like on radio.
Live from New Hampshire.
But he would have hit this guy. He would have hit this guy. I'm
I hope VH1 shows all of that. They don't pussy out and, like,
It's a half hour. I mean, but you know what? If you ever thought about doing a reality show, man, it is such a pain in the ass. There's a guy with a boom mic around him all the time.
Oh, that's so annoying.
Like, he comes up to me saying hi to me. Now, you don't know, are we on? Are we acting? Are we just having a conversation?
Right, is he provoking you like a conversation?
Yeah, does he want something here for the camera?
And then I signed 8 releases. God knows I probably owe them money.
They're not here for you. They're here for Dice. You dumb fuck. Goodbye. You fucking prick. Go ahead. That's a fucking 3-year-old. They gotta throw you out of here. Cause you got too drunk. He's drooling on himself. Go home. Let mommy jerk you off in the bathtub. There's fucking zero of a human being. And then mommy's waiting for you. Go ahead. Go ahead, baby boy, she'll suck your dick. Fucking creep. That's what I do. That's the guy you want. That's the guy you get.
No, I don't seem to like that. I just went, the crowd gets bored again. Uh-oh.
Jesus.
Oh, able in a fucker? What do you think, fat girls don't have balls? They look at you, eat my pussy. Eat my pussy. Girls. Let me tell you something about your little pussies, okay? Let me tell you how good your little... Let me tell you, no matter how you prepare these things, no matter how you shower them off, whatever you spray on them to disinfect them with Lysol and Raid, D40, off, by the time we go down there, it smells like a foot shoe for 12 fucking hours.
Wow. Well, tough crowd.
Again.
What did they come out for this crowd?
Artie, I guess.
That is a weird, you know, like you want to have a miserable time on a Saturday night and you're willing to pay.
I've played the room before, and if they're not hostile, it's a great bunch of people.
Eat my fucking pussy. And today these chicks, they shove it down to street level. I like them big hairy bastards that do hang on their fucking panties like Bozo the Clown. And I ride her around the room holding her by the love handles. You know, the ones on the side of her fucking neck. Eat my fucking pussy. Now you gotta go down there and make a production number out of it. Gotta make noises from... Should I bring a rattle kill? Find my G-spot and be one there working your hand. I can't find the A and a half spot. I gotta find your fucking G-spot. Eat your own fucking pussy. That's what I'm saying. You won this fucking thing. You don't see.
Hey, crowd's going berserk.
And also
the amount of alcohol consumption. Wow. I can't even tell you. I mean, there's like eight bars all over the place. So there's 2,000 people getting up drinking, doing shots. Fucking the guys in the front row use the stage as a bar.
Well, you know what it is? When a lot of fans get together, you almost don't need a comedian. You could just sit there and network and talk and drink and like meet people.
A lot of these gigs at rock clubs, I do just become like the host of a party. I'm like, oh, what do you want to say? What are you doing?
He's back. His asshole face back.
Uh-oh. This is what Rob's talking about. I think the guy got back in.
Somehow he got back in.
This fucking cocksucker got back. Where the fuck is this guy? Oh, fuck this. Where's the jacket, Matt?
Right, here's for the jacket for the phone.
I wasn't going to do it. I don't do it no more. You know what? Max.
Does the son look like him, or does he look like the mom?
His son is 16 years old. He's like real thin. Yeah. He's a good looking kid. He's got a, you know, nice guy, nice kid too. Really, really nice kid.
So Max brings up the jacket.
Yeah,
it's a special Dice nursery rhyme jacket.
Right. I think once the guy got back in, he said, "Oh fuck this, give me the jacket to end it." But Max had to bring it up. Yeah.
Yeah. Right. So does he win the crowd back with the nursery rhyme?
And they seem to like the nursery rhymes. Yeah.
Normally don't do this, no.
But in light of this craziness,
because they all know the nurse. That's the good thing. They all know the nursery rhymes. So they do it along with them.
Muffin sat on a coffin. Eat it. A curds of lay. Long came a spidey, sat down beside him, said, "Hey, what's in your bowl, bitch?"
Oh! Now they like that.
Don't do it no more.
Maybe you ought to do it more. Seem to like it.
That's only 5 minutes.
Oh, man. So, you were part of a reality show. Then what did you do? You went out drinking with Ross?
Then we stayed in Boston. It's a 45-minute drive to Boston without traffic.
Radio Land, the one, the only, the unmistakably original, Diamond David Lee Roth here on your Monday morning. Wow! We got a little bit of a change here. No big deal. The party's just moving to a different room, and the doors are wide open. You don't even need a key to this shindig. We just need you to show up with your two big, beautiful ears. Today, we're going to have some special things happening on the inaugural David Lee Roth Show. Now, I don't even know if the sun is shining outside, but I don't care, because I brought the sun right here into the room with me, and now I'm going to send it right out to you people on your radio dial. Oh, yeah!
To my man Howard Stern, I want to say hasta luego, baby. It's David Lee Roth on the new Diamond Radio. I'm the latest sensation across the nation. Just a gigolo on your radio station. That's D as in David and D on your dial. D as in DJ, because I'm crazy and wild. The time has come for a new superstar, and that's David Lee Roth, not Sammy Hagar. So stay tuned, my friends, and enjoy the show. It's DLR on Diamond David Radio. Humble and babble and zeebla bubble, humble and babble and zeebla bop. Diamond David Radio is here, ready to rock. The party has arrived with the new Jew in town. Grab your spandex and let's get down. Well, this is the new morning show, where this is the show where you get more than you bargain for, because the show is a bargain, because why? The show is for free, baby. No pay. You know what? This is the show where we're going to try a lot of different things. We're going to have callers calling. They're just going to talk to me. We're going to have a good time with my friends. I call you guys my friends because it's a party, and I only party with people who I'm close with. You are my new friends. So, let me see, what do we got going on here? We're going to play songs, you know. We're going to play a lot of my friends from the old days. Some of the people I might have played with. Some of these people you might even know. Some of these people you might even be working with now. They might be the person that's next to you on the train going to work. They might be the person you see on the street. They might even be the person that's serving you coffee now. Those are some of those bands might not even be around anymore. Hell, some of those bands might even be in another country as a red-headed stepchild somewhere. I don't know what the hell I'm talking about. Sewer. Some people, you know, a lot of people said when they found out David Lee Roth is going to do this show, they asked me, they said, Dave, how are you going to get up so early every morning? And I looked them straight in the eyes and I said, you know what? I'm just going to sleep at about 10 or 11 o'clock. This is the middle of the day for me, baby. So when you're up working, that's when Dave Lee Roth is sleeping. I'm home sleeping when you're just having dinner. I'm just getting going at about 1, 2 o'clock in the morning, baby. That's why I'm here in New York City. I'm just giving you stuff that we can work with here. We have a good, you know, a lot of people come to me. They say, Dave, you party a lot. They say, Dave, you party too much. They say, Dave, you over-excess things. They say, Dave, you get into too many things. They say, Dave, you get into too much trouble. And I look them straight back in the eye, and I say to them, some people look at life as the glass being half full or half empty. I say the glass is half empty, so I have an excuse to pour more Jack Daniels to get to the next day. Wow! Whoa! It's time for David Lee Roth's Views on the News. You know, I want to say one thing right here. You know, it's a funny thing with this Tom Cruise. Everybody's getting down on him because he's jumping up and down on couches. You know, he's flipping out on Oprah. He's doing this. He's doing that. He's going on interviews. He's talking out against this and talking out against that. I want to say one thing. I think I kind of agree with Tom Cruise a little bit, because I'll tell you what. I traveled the world loving everybody I ever got my hands on. And you saw Diamond Dave go on stage every night and do kicks, do leaps, do tumble salts. And nobody ever questioned Diamond David Lee Roth. That's right. I was doing it every night. Nobody thought I was crazy. Well, that was because I fell in love in a different city on every tour. And, you know, I was always in love. Always falling in love. So I can kind of relate to where Tom Cruise is coming from. So you know what? I say kudos to you there, Mr. Cruise. And let me see. We got some other stuff in the news. What do we got? We got Kirstie Alley. Let me tell you something. I remember Kirstie Alley when me and all my friends had a crush on her. And I looked at her. She could crush me and all my friends. Wow! Let me see what else we got going on over here in the news. We got a lot of crazy things happening in the world right now. You know what? Let me see. Let me go through the tabloids and see what we got going on over here. We got Jennifer Aniston and Brad Pitt. Well, let me think about this for a second here. I mean, did you really think this Hollywood marriage was ever going to last? You know, many years ago, I remember when Eddie and Valerie got married. Everybody was like, you know, oh, it's a match made in heaven. They look like brother and sister. They look like people who were bred to be together. They were born to be together. The heavens above put them together. And of course, like everything else, it fell apart over time. This is the entertainment. This is the business, as the Italians say in the movies. This is the business we chose. And everything over time goes sour because there's just too much out there to have a good time with. And you know what I mean? There's just too many things. We're human beings. Okay, and you know we're gonna get ourselves into trouble. That's what it's all about. It's about getting into trouble, problem solving. Life is problem solving, and being in this, that's what it is. You get into one problem, you solve it. Now you solve it with another girl, you solve it with another drink, you solve it with another drug, and you just keep going until the point where you can't go anymore, and then you just have to solve yourself and clean up and do it all over again. So. I really relate to a lot of these people. Look at this. I'm seeing a picture of Fran Drescher. Fran Drescher in the net. How you doing? Hey, what's happening? I met her once at a party. She comes in. Hey, Dave, how you doing? How's everything? You mind if I said, oh, you know what? I said, we got to get this girl on our next album. Look at this. Look at this. Here's another thing we got. We got Michael Douglas and Catherine Zeta-Jones. Catherine Zeta-Jones. I'll tell you, this is another one. If this, you know what, it'll last by the, because by the time he hits 90, I think she'll just about be 40 at that time. She'll just be hitting 40 and she'll be on to someone else. My prediction for the fight, Catherine Zeta-Jones and Brad Pitt by 50. That's for sure. Let me see what else we got here. We got, look at this other one. She's got a face like a dog, this one. Gwyneth Paltrow. My God, what the hell is she thinking about? The guy in Coldplay. You know, he was the guy that everybody, he knocked Gwyneth Paltrow. You think that was the first girl? This is a guy who could have went out on tour. At least should have got married at least three or four tours into it, you know? He hits Gwyneth Paltrow. He sticks with that. I don't know. I don't see the appeal there, but whatever. Let me see what else we got going on up here. I'm just flipping through the pages, you know? Just flipping through the pages. We got, how about this? How about Desperate Housewives? Desperate Housewives, you know. That should have been done by Valerie Bertinelli. Case closed. Next subject. On the news. Oh, okay. All right. Okay, let's take a phone call. Go ahead, Dave. You're on the air.
I don't know who's doing this radio show, because I'm the real David LeBron. Wow!
I think I know who this is on the line. It's that ass clown who used to try and impersonate me on that old morning show here. Remember, boys and girls, always beware of cheap imitations, you know. I ought to sue your ass for all the calls my lawyers received due to your lame attempts at prank calls, tarnishing my reputation.
Wow, sue me!
What are you, the singer from a second-rate Van Halen cover band or something like that?
I'm the real Diamond David Lee Roth, loud and funny, your hot steaming ears. You're lucky I don't head down there and throw you a beat right now. Taekwondo style, my friend. Jump back, what's that sound? I'm kicking your ass and you're falling on the ground.
Hey, that would have been pretty good if you were a better singer and sounded more like me. I have one question for you, though. What did music ever do to you, huh? Your services are no longer needed here, because the real McCoy is here and here to stay. This is David Lee Roth. We're back in here. You know, this is our first show, you know, so you're going to bear with us a little bit. You know, we're going to get to something here right now that I think is going to be pretty interesting. We have our first interview. You know, I was walking around the radio station here before the show, and I noticed there was a very pretty intern that was walking around. So I figured I'd have her come in and have her maybe interview and maybe talk to me for a little bit. So I'm going to introduce to you right now. Matter of fact, I'm going to let her introduce herself. Here you go. Why don't you step up to the microphone?
Hi, I'm Claudia.
Hey, Claudia, how you doing? What's happening, sweetheart?
Nothing's happening.
Wow, look at you, hot stuff. And let me ask you a question. How old are you?
I'm 18.
18 years old. You know, I have spandex at home that are older than you.
I'm sure you do.
You remember what spandex was?
I don't know what spandex is.
You don't know what spandex is? That stuff that goes on your skin, gets really tight, accentuates your curves,
mm-hmm,
you know?
Mm-hmm.
You don't like that stuff?
No.
You don't like that stuff? Well, let me ask you a question. What do you like? What are your interests?
I like to party. I like to...
Now, you're in the right place. Yeah. You like to party. You're with the party animal, the king of partying, Diamond David Lee Roth right here, sweetheart. Wow! Yeah! This is going to be a great show. I'm getting a good vibe from you. You're giving the show a good vibe. You're giving the listeners, the people out there, far and wide a good vibe. You see, you hear what I'm... You're feeling me? Is that a term now?
I'm feeling you.
You're feeling me now? That's good. I'm feeling you, sweetheart.
Thank you.
That's right. Hey, you know, so let me ask you a question. So you know who Van Halen is? You remember Van Halen?
A little bit. It's kind of old for me, but...
Well, what is this out there? So you remember... What do you remember most about Van Halen?
I mean, I've heard of them.
You just heard of them?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I've heard of faraway countries, but I've never been there.
Right. That's kind of like me with Van Halen. I've never really been there.
Well, would you like to go to a faraway country? Would you like to come on a journey with Diamond Dave?
Yeah,
that's right. See, ooh, that's right there, sweetheart. That's good stuff, hot stuff. So let me ask you a question here. So you remember Van Halen. Now, do you remember David Lee Roth? Do you remember the days of David Lee Roth doing the splits? Is that anything to relate to? Maybe if you were in a dance class or two. You know, did you ever take a dance class?
Yeah, ballet for a little bit.
Didn't you? Remember you used to stretch out? You used to throw your legs up? Remember that, there's that bar that went across the whole room? You know, you'd go over there. You'd do a couple of bendovers, you know. You'd put your leg up. You'd stretch out, right?
Mm-hmm, exactly. That's what I did.
That was my favorite position, sweetheart.
Oh, I bet.
That's right. Well, I'll tell you what, you're a good interview.
Thank you.
Is there anything on your mind? Anything you want to talk about? Because the David Lee Roth Show is just about verbal, syllable suicide, sweetheart. You can just say whatever you want. Anything that's on your mind, you just let it out. Let's get a little bit of your academic studies. Where are you going to school?
I go to American University.
American University. Ooh, that's right. Red, white, and blue, baby.
Oh, yeah.
American University.
Yep.
Oh, look at you. And you look like an all-American girl.
I am. Pretty much.
All right. What are you studying?
Studying communications.
That's what we're doing right now.
Oh,
so it looks like you're going to get a couple of brownie points.
Hell yeah.
Excommunicado.
Mm-hmm.
So communications. What do you aspire to be? What do you want to be when you grow up?
I kind of want to host my own TV show.
Like David Lee Roth.
Yeah.
You want to be kind of like David Lee Roth?
I want to be just like you.
Oh my God! See, now I got a couple of fans already. We're gonna start nuclear, and we're gonna build out and blow this thing off. We're gonna blow the roof off the United States. All right. You have any jokes you want to tell? Anything you want to tell to the audience?
No, not really. I'm not a big joke person.
Well, I got a joke I want to share with you.
Okay. I'm not good at them, though, but go ahead.
Oh, that's okay. We have time, you know?
Right.
You know, it's all right. But I got a joke for you. Why did the chicken cross the road?
You got me.
To get to the new Diamond David Lee Roth radio show, sweetheart. The DLR Diamond Dave, Dave in the Rough, Diamond Dave ice cream. That's what you want. You see, ain't this better than some Stump the Buoy and Lesbos, you know? And what's the wheel of sex, you know? Wheel of sex, you know? This is the wheel of the diamond, baby! The Diamond David Lee Roth. Wow! That's what you're gonna get! The wheel of Diamond David Lee Roth. We're just gonna go around, around the world. We're gonna keep it going. We're gonna fly from continent to continent, near and far, here and wide. As we're gonna keep going, this is the year of the stud. The year of the jungle stud comes to the city and makes the city. You know what? FCC is your friend with Diamond David Lee Roth. The FCC, we don't put down the FCC here. We say the FCC, we embrace the FCC. You know, we want to come up for lunch? Lunch is on us. You want to go to Nobu? We'll take you to Nobu. We're going to give you a good time with Diamond David Lee Roth. We're going to invite the FCC in, and if they got any hot ladies or anybody who wants to come on the show, we'll talk to them. We want to hear their point of view. That's the point of the David Lee Roth Show. Is to hear everybody. Even if we don't agree with everything we're saying, in the Diamond David Lee Roth world, FCC stands for Friendly Communications Cool, I don't know, whatever you want to, you fill in the blanks. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for a contest on the David Lee Roth Show. And the name of the contest is Name That Sensational Diamond Dave Tune. Get the sensational Diamond.